internal structure of leaves. If a typical leaf is cut transversely and examined under a microscope, three regions will be observed: the epidermis, the mesophyll, and veins, referred to as the vascular bundle. The epidermis is a single layer of cells covering the entire surface of the leaf. It is the skin of the leaf. The epidermis on the lower surface of the blade often have more stomata. The function of the epidermis is to protect the delicate tissue inside the leaf. A coating of waxy cutin, that is the cuticle, is normally present, although it may not be visible with ordinary light microscope without being stained. The lower epidermis of most plants generally resembles the upper epidermis, but it typically has a thinner layer of cutin and is perforated by numerous tiny pores called the stomata. Now to the mesophyll and veins. Most photosynthesis takes place in the mesophyll between the two epidermal layers, with two regions often being distinguishable. The uppermost mesophyll consists of compactly stacked column-shaped parenchyma cells, often in two or more layers. This region is called the palisade mesophyll and may contain more than 80% of the leaf's chloroplasts. This dense arrangement of chloroplast-packed cells maximizes the capturing of light hitting the upper leaf surface. The lower region, consisting of loosely arranged spherical parenchyma cells with abundant air spaces separating them, is called the spongy mesophyll. Its cells also have numerous chloroplasts. The loose arrangement of cells in the shady side of the leaf allows for free movement of carbon dioxide taken in through the stomata. Parenchyma tissue with chloroplasts is called chlorenchyma. Chlorenchyma tissue is found in the outer part of the stems of herbaceous plants as well as in leaves. Inside the leaf, the surface of mesophyll cell in contact with the air are moist. If the moisture level decreases below a certain point, the stomata close, significantly reducing further drying out of the leaf. Now to the veins, which are also the vascular bundle. Veins of various sizes are scattered throughout the mesophyll. They consist of xylem and phloem tissues surrounded by a jacket of thick walled parenchyma called the bundle sheets. The vein gives the leaf its skeleton. The phloem transports sugars and other carbohydrates from the leaf to other parts of the plant, such as the stem and roots. Water, sometimes located more than 100 meters above the ground, is brought into the leaf by the xylem, which, like the phloem, is part of a vast network of plumbing throughout the plant. Because veins run in many directions in the network, especially in dicot, it is common when examining a cross-section of a leaf under the microscope to see veins cut transversely, lengthwise, and at a tangent, all in the same section. Monocot leaves, besides having a parallel vein, usually do not have the mesophyll differentiated into palisade and spongy layer. Some monocot leaves, for example those of grasses, have large thin-walled bulliform cells on either side of the main central vein, which is the midrib, towards the upper surface. Under dry conditions, that is during dry season, the bulliform cells partly collapse, causing the leaf blade to fold or roll. The folding or rolling reduces transpiration rate. So, in summary, leaves are similar to solar panels in that they are covered with a transparent epidermis that admits light to the interior, and many twist on their petals so that their flat surfaces are inclined to the sun throughout the day. The lower and often the upper surfaces of leaves have pores, which are called stomata. Stomata permit air circulation and facilitate photosynthesis. Leaves also respire, accumulate waste, and eliminate excess moisture via transpiration. And in summary of the leaf arrangements are the internal structures of leaf. It contains the stomata, the mesophyll, and veins. And the stomata at the lower epidermis usually contain numerous stomata, each formed by a pair of gut cells that regulate both evaporation of water vapor from the leaf and gas exchange between the interior and the atmosphere. Also, the mesophyll between the upper epidermis and the lower epidermis may be divided into an upper palisade layer, which consists of rows of parenchyma cells containing numerous chloroplasts, and a lower spongy layer in which the parenchyma cells are loosely arranged. Veins traverse the mesophyll. Please make sure you like this video, click the subscription button if you are yet to do so, and share the video. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.